If you have followed the Outdoor Gear Review over the years, you know that I have a high opinion for Fjällräven. 99.9% of the time, their products excel. They can be very expensive, but at the same time, also very affordable. It really depends on the product that you're looking at. This is one of those rare instances where the Fjällräven product in question, which happens to be the trekking gaiters, has absolutely failed. This is, in my opinion, a terrible product. It is not worth your money. It is one of the poorest performers when it comes to gaiters that I've ever tested out. I purchased this product with my own money sometime last year, and since purchasing them, I have been disappointed. The overall quality here is excellent. The overall durability, excellent. But the overall performance is very, very lacking. So bad, in fact, that I would not recommend these gaiters. What you're looking at is the backside of the gaiters. You have a draw pull up here at the top so you can pull this tight around your leg. Flipping over to the front, you have a Velcro cover which blocks the zipper. Going down, you have the strap for your boot. You have a snap up here at the top, a snap at the bottom, and you also have a lace hook to secure this to your boot. The outside shell material is 100% polyester, and the membrane is 100% polyurethane. As far as the zipper goes, I have no idea what brand this is. There's no labeling. I'm surprised to see that it's not a YKK zipper. Also, something else that I find interesting about these gaiters, they are not made with the G1000 material, which Fjällräven is known for. Fjällräven offers many different types of gaiters. All of them use, from what I understand, the G1000, except for these. So you don't have the YKK zippers, and you do not have the G1000. And because of these facts, you would expect the price to be lower for these gaiters, but that's not the case. The retail price of these is $70, which is a premium for gaiters, as you could find some really good gaiters for around 40 bucks. In general, high-end gaiters run around $70 to $80. When it comes to sizing, I'm not really sure how this works with Fjällräven. On their website, it says that these could be ordered in sizes from extra, extra small all the way up to extra, extra large. But the thing is, these arrived and it states that it is one size fits all. And when I purchased these from Camp Saver last year, I wasn't given the option to select a size. So I'm not really sure what the discrepancy is there. From what I've read online, it is one size fits all. But the website, the Fjällräven website, does give you the option to select different sizes. A little bit of a mystery there. The weight of the one size fits all version, the one that I have, is 10.5 ounces. Colors. This is available in stone gray and forest green. This is the forest green version. Putting on the gaiters and also taking them off is very easy. You wrap it around from the back. You put the boot strap over your boot. I like to snap it up here at the top. Make sure my pants are pulled down. Then move over to the zipper. Secure the Velcro, do the snaps, and then attach to the lace point. Just in case you're not familiar with what gaiters do, the purpose of these is to be waterproof, breathable, and to block snow and debris from getting into your shoes. They also can protect your pants. Now with these are high-rise gaiters. They go from the bottom of your boot all the way up your knee, and that's to keep you dry, to keep you protected, and to keep the snow out. And with those aspects being understood, let's move over to the pros and cons, starting with the cons. While the number of cons that I have for these gaiters is much less than the pros, the cons are so big, they're so important, and that is the reason why I cannot recommend these. First off, when it comes to being breathable, they are absolutely not at the least little bit. You could wear these for a hike, and when you stop, when you take these off, if you're hiking long enough, you will feel your clothing getting wet with body perspiration. And that's because these gaiters do not breathe. They are 100% non-breathable, and they will collect more moisture on the inside than any other gaiter you've ever seen. These are, in fact, the worst performers I've ever tested out. On numerous hikes with these gaiters, hiking up the mountain, going about 4 or 5 miles, I stop, take them off, and they are soaking wet. But worse than that, my clothing, my pants are soaking wet. That is completely unacceptable for a pair of gaiters. Some moisture buildup is to be expected, but not all materials are created equal. 100% polyester with this polyurethane coating, it's not breathable at all. And that makes for a very dangerous product. The last trip that I did out with these, we hiked maybe 6 miles up a mountain. It was roughly 19 degrees, something like that. I got to camp, set up camp, It was time to basically get ready for the night. I took these off. There was water, streams of water running down this material, and my pants were soaking wet. Again, that is completely unacceptable. It is this big reason that I do not recommend these gaiters. You have to have a product that will be not only waterproof, but also breathable at the same time. Otherwise, why wear them? If you're going to get soaking wet no matter what, what is the point? The next con that I have here are with the boot straps. As you can see, you have quite a bit of material here sticking out, and there's no way to secure this. With most gaiters, you do have like a little bit of a sleeve here or a buckle where you can secure this into place, but you cannot do that with these. So you have this material just constantly flapping around. You can cut this off if you want to. I prefer not to because I like to use my gaiters with different types of boots and shoes. If you cut it off, it does limit things somewhat. Stuffing them up in the gaiter doesn't work. It will come out. The next con that I have here is that for $70, these perform terribly. It's not the G1000 material. You do not have YKK zippers with these. It's just an oddity, in my opinion. This feels like a heavy duty product, but at the same time, it feels like Fjallraven has cut corners. Yeah, I don't know, it's very strange. Now, moving on to the pros. As I mentioned before, the pros that I have for this product, it's a much longer list. First off, the build quality of these is excellent. Every stitch is perfect. The materials themselves feel very robust. In fact, these are very, very tough gaiters. Even with all of the miles that I've put on these, they show very little use and wear. The coloring, the styles are excellent in my opinion. You have the black up top, you have the green, very sharp looking in my opinion. Not only are these hard wearing, very robust, very strong, but these are impressively waterproof. Without a doubt, it blocks out the snow, it blocks out the moisture, you can go post-holing through snow, and you're going to be okay. You could be walking through wet bushes, you will be okay. The zipper, even though I have no idea what brand this is, it is very smooth, it does not get caught, and it does feel fairly strong. It doesn't feel cheap by any means. The overall fit is excellent. It does a good job of keeping the snow out of your shoe, out of your boot. The features that it has are very good. You have the draw pull in the back to pull it tight. You have the lace loop or the lace hook. You have the snaps, the zipper, the Velcro, and of course, the boot strap. They're easy to put on and also take off. And that pretty much wraps it up as far as the pros and cons go. As you all can see there, the list of pros is much higher. But the cons here, it's one of those situations where the bad outweighs the good because the bad is so terrible. A product that will soak you is not a product that's good for the outdoors, especially if you are using these as they were designed to be used. In cold weather, in the snow, you do not need a product that leaves you soaking wet, and that's what these do. And that's just simply unacceptable. To summarize my review of this product, the overall performance of this is truly unacceptable. While the quality is very good, it is waterproof. The overall breathability is just too much to get over. The price is too high, in my opinion, for the performance of this. If this cost 20 bucks, I would say okay, right? That's what I would expect for 20 bucks. But for $70, and for a product that's from Fjallraven, I would expect much, much better. Fjallraven, and yes, that is the way that Americans pronounce it, is a company that has earned my respect over the years. I believe 99% of their products I have enjoyed using that I've given favorable reviews to. Now, of course, there are some things which I simply can't get in. They're just too expensive for me to even contemplate testing out. And that's because I'm 100% agenda free. I purchase just about everything here that you see on the channel with my own money. No one owns me, which is different from many channels here on YouTube. But anyways, usually Fjallraven is right on the money when it comes to their products. They know what it takes to make a good product. Backpack, tent, sleeping bag. They should know what makes a good pair of gaiters, but they dropped the ball here. They really did. The one thing that you have to keep in mind when it comes to a pair of gaiters is that there are two main aspects, waterproofness and breathability. And if one of those doesn't work out, if one of those fails, then you have a bad product. A pair of gaiters has to be waterproof and it also has to be breathable. And if either one of those isn't right, the product's no good. 100% non-breathable. You can wear these for a short distance and it will blow your mind how much moisture is inside of these. And once you get to that point, you have a problem that you have to solve. First off, you take these off, you have to dry them up. You may have to put them next to a fire, wipe them off, or it will freeze, be covered in ice the next day when you put them on. You also have to dry out your clothes. So do you carry additional clothes with you? Do you change? Do you dry those out next to a fire? Unfortunately, these gaiters cause more problems than they are useful. And because of that, I do not recommend them. If you are interested in a good pair of gaiters, Outdoor Designs makes an excellent pair with the Alpine. Outdoor Research has the Crocs. They are fantastic. Black Diamond has some, and so on. Some of those are less expensive than these. All of them will perform better than these. And folks, that wraps it up. Make sure to comment down below and share your thoughts about these gaiters. What do you all think about them? Do you have any experience with them? I did a search on YouTube for the trekking gaiters from Fjällräven. I found one video from a guy who just got them in and he was giving a review for them. So it was a worthless video. He was talking about how great he thinks they will be. Come on, folks. Come on. If you're going to review gear, get out there and test it out. Let's stop the BS, right? But yeah. For this agenda-free review, that is it. If you want to support the channel, please do so through Patreon here on YouTube. Hit the thumbs up because that does help a lot. Until next time, everyone, strength and honor. See ya.